Hello guys, welcome to today's video. So today we'll be discussing the chapter 17 of the book Aviation and Business Management. You know, the topic of discussion today is supply chain management. Now what happens is the moment you need to produce from raw material to the final product, as to how you will deliver to the customer, all these components involves the supply chain. So how you'll be supplying the items which are needed to yourself, and finally making the product, and then finally giving it to the hands of the customer. This entire process is the supply chain system. So we'll see the what are the components and what the management says. You know, supply chain is a system of organizations, people's activities, informations and resources. So all these are involved in supplying the product or service to a customer. This is the key. The end aim is to supply the product or service to a customer. So for that, what all you need? You need to have contacts with other organizations who can supply the raw material to you. Then you need to have a team of who consists of people. Then those people have to perform some activities. And then with the available information and resources, you need to carry out the functions so that at the end you supply the product to the customer. So this is what supply chain system consists of. You know, what are the activities involve the transformation of natural resources, raw materials into finished product that is delivered to the end customer, as I have just said. So if you come to the proper definition in management, it is the design, planning, execution, control and monitoring of the supply chain activities with the objective of creating net value, building competitive infrastructure, leveraging the worldwide logistics, synchronizing supply with the demand and measuring the performance globally. So as I have just said, you know, first you need to have, you need to plan, then you need to execute, then you also need to have a control, and how you will, you need to have the control over the entire process, how you will be delivering it. So for that, you need to have a good infrastructure in place. And then logistics. Logistics is the key. Logistics is all about the transportation and supplying the, means transporting the material from one place to another. And then you need to synchronize the supplies, means all the components, they need to be in sync with each other. You know, the best example of the supply chain management is Amazon or Flipkart. You know, what they'll be doing is they will be having the product, and then they are creating a system such that the product from their warehouse is finally given to the customer. So they have a world-class logistic support, and then everything is sync. They are able to tell you beforehand as to within how many days they will be able to deliver the product, because they have a world-class synchronizing supply and they have a very good logistic support. Only with the help of this, they are able to tell us beforehand how it will able to deliver. So like you can say, Amazon are the masters of the supply chain management. They are able to deliver the products. So it is the handling of the entire production flow of a good of service. You know, in management, what happens is once you understand the meaning, you can paraphrase it to like what in whatever way you want. We have seen 3 to 4 definitions of supply chain management. But once you have understood the concept, depending upon the options, you can clearly answer the question. So it involves from the raw components all the way to delivering the final product, as I have just said. From you have the raw components, or you have decided what is the raw components, from there what the final product would be. So what are the important components? Components is you need to have a plan or the strategy as to what are resources required to meet the customer demand for a company's product or service. So you need to plan as to what product you need to deliver the final product, means what are resources you need, what are the raw materials you need, so that you will be able to deliver the final product. Let's say you are writing a book. Let's say you are a publisher. Then what you need? You need to have good paper, good printing quality. So all these are raw materials. So how you will turn these raw materials into the final product? You need to plan. So that is one of the components of the supply chain. Then is who will be supplying the raw materials to you? That is the next question. Then you need to choose who all will be supplying those raw materials like paper and other items. So choose suppliers to provide the goods and the services need to create the product. Then establish a process to manage, to monitor and manage the supplier relationships. So whoever is supplying those raw products, raw materials to you, you need to have a good relationship with them. And then you need to establish a process such that you can always keep a track how the raw materials are coming to you. Are they coming in a cost effective manner is also important. Next is once you have the raw materials, then you manufacture. So this is the third step. Then organize the activities so that you accept the raw material, you take the raw material, you manufacture the product, then you test for the quality, and then you finally package for shipping, and then you will schedule for delivery. This is the general process which we all know. So this is one of the components. Next is you have scheduled for delivery. Next is what you will do. You will do a delivery and logistics. So coordinate the customer orders. As and when the orders will come, then you have to schedule the deliveries, dispatch loads, invoice the customer, and receive the payments. You have decided that you will give the product, let's say, on 15th of March. Customer has raised an order. Then what you will do, you will plan. You will schedule the delivery for 15th of March. According to that, you will decide how you will be dispatching all these products to the customer. Then you need to generate the invoice and then how you will receive the payments. All these are part of the delivery and logistics. So this is also a key component of the supply chain management. Next is return system. Let's say you have delivered the product, but then the customer is not satisfied with the product and he wants to return the product. Then you need to have a good supply, means good network of or a process to take back these defective items. You know how Amazon and Flipkart works. They have a return policy, like whenever the product is defective or they have not returned, the customer is not happy with the product. So they have a return system well in place. So in this chapter, we have just touched the basic concepts of the supply chain management. We have not gone into depth, but then it is not necessary also to go into that much depth, because we have understood how the supply chain system works, what are all the components needed from raw materials to final delivery of the product, and also need to have a return system in place. So these are all the components that are involved. If you have liked the video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos. And thank you for watching.